What's poppin' T-Squad? It's me, Keisha, and I'm here with tonight's All Tea, All Shade Poe Season 2, Episode 9 review. Alright, so on tonight's episode, we see Blanca's business has been mysteriously burned down. Frederica appears and basically admits to doing it and says that she raised the insurance on the building because she thought that something like this may happen. So I was like, Frederica, you big raggedy bitch, you. I want Blanca to have the last laugh with this whole situation. Hopefully she can come back from this because Frederica is the fucking devil. And it's so sad because we all know how bad Blanca wanted this, how hard she worked for it. Her dreams was coming true, and to have this villainous character take away her dream was just so fucked up. So Electra is at her job in the heat, wondering where all the Johns are at. And one of the other girls there at the club tells her that, you know, it's summertime, so all the Johns go out to like Martha's Vineyard and go on vacation and stuff like that. So Electra forgot about one of her Johns that was in the room. So she's like, oh shit, I cannot have another John down my ass. So she rushed in the room, and the guy asked her, you know, to leave him there overnight because he likes being in isolation. She was like, nope, not gonna do that. Makes me feel uncomfortable. So he tells her that he has a beach house, and then her ears perk up. So she was like, ooh, beach house, money, vacation. Okay, great. So the girls from the House of Abundance are all at Blanca's dying in the heat. They got the fans going, but they are all still sweating their asses off. And ain't nothing worse than being hot in the summertime, baby. Oh, I hate this shit. I cannot be hot for shit. As you can see, I got a fan right here. I need air on me at all times. I'm one of them people that even in the wintertime, I have a fan on me. I cannot stand to be hot. So they talk about Frederica burning down the salon, and they tell Blanca not to give up. But she says, you know, she's lost everything. She's lost her children. She's lost her salon. She's basically just giving up at this point. So Angel wonders why they aren't at Electra's place, since Electra has an air conditioner. And Electra slips and says, because it's beginning to smell. And Lulu like, why? And Blanca and Electra just look at each other because they know that she got a dead body sitting in her goddamn closet. So Electra makes up this story about a Jamaican lady in the building making the apartment sink and this and that. So Electra suggests that they go on a girls trip the next morning because she came up with this bright idea to get out the heat. They're gonna go to her John Joe's beach house. So the next day, Angel and Electra are at Electra's apartment in their swimsuits and everything. And let me know, have all of the ladies on the show had the surgery, you know, down yonder or whatever? Because I was wondering, like, are they tucking or have they had the surgery? You know, because I was like, if they tucking, they have done a wonderful tucking job. Like, they on some RuPaul's Drag Race style of tucking. But I think they all have had the surgery, if I'm not mistaken. But Angel looked great in her swimsuit, so did Electra. Lulu come out and she says, you know, she's afraid because she thinks that she's gonna get clocked because they going out basically in nothing during the daylight. And they basically tell her, girl, you look great, you know, you look good. So she and Angel both ask Electra, like, what is that smell? And she was like, my air fresheners or whatever. So then Blanca arrived, and everybody like, oh bitch, what the hell you got on? Blanca look like she about to go build somebody's house. Like, she straight up look like a nigga. And Electra tells her, look, girl, I'm gonna go get you something to work, because we all can't be looking like in Vogue, bitch, and you up here looking like the brat. Like, no. So she was like, no, I don't want you going to give me nothing else because I don't look like y'all. There's just certain things that I can't wear. She doesn't like me and calling her a tranny and this and that during the day. She just don't want it. So Angel tells her that people will always have something to say. She can't be worried about that. So Angel gives Blanca a makeover at this store, and Electra like, are y'all done eating each other's pussy so we can the fuck go? Honey, I died. That shit was so funny as hell to me when Electra said that shit. So they all get in the car and they head out to the shore. And we learned that Electra can't drive for shit. She don't even have a license, bitch. So it's like, Electra ass be rigging up some shit, baby. Electra is my type of girl. So they arrive at the John's Beach House, and it's a mansion. It's a gorgeous mansion. And she tells them that they can go anywhere in that mansion, but that the garage is off limits. And they all like, why? So she takes them down to the garage, and they see Joe in a cage in his latex bodysuit with his face covered. He got earmuffs on his ears, and he's tied up. And Blanca looking like, bitch, we not doing this again. Like, I knew it was some bullshit with this goddamn trip. So Blanca tells the other girls to go upstairs so she can talk to Electra alone. And she's like, bitch, we're not doing this. I'm not helping you with another dead body, bitch. No, ma'am. So she gets Joe to tell her that, you know, he's down for this. It's what he likes to do or whatever. So he was like, you know, I love being tied up and they can come check on him tomorrow. Like, leave me the fuck alone. Just leave me down here. She was like, no, motherfucker. We don't come check on you every motherfucker hour on hour. Like, we on MTV, goddammit. So the girls are at the beach. And it's the first time Blanca has ever even seen the ocean, and she didn't even live that far from it her whole life. And I've heard that about a lot of people, like even like people that I know that live like in Los Angeles, or even people that live like in Chicago that have never even been to the lake or never been to the ocean. Like, that just amazes me how some people have not experienced things that are in their own hometown. Have you ever had something like that going in your life where it's a big monument or a big thing in your city and you have never even gone to see it? Let me know down below. So, like, for me, that'd be like me saying I've never been to the Arch. Been to the Arch million times. But anywho, so, Blanca wants to go in the ocean, but don't nobody want to go with her because, you know, Lulu and Electra like, bitch, I am too beat for this shit. No, ma'am, Pam. And Angel don't want to go because Angel don't know how to swim. But Blanca talks her into it. So they go into the water. They go to the water and as they're walking, they're talking. And Blanca asks Angel, has she kept her promise to stop using drugs? And she says, yes. I don't know if I truly don't believe her, but she says that she's not using drugs and that she knows that Blanca has people watching her to make sure that she isn't using anymore. And she says that she hasn't touched anything. So they go and start frolicking in the water. And then we go back to Electra and Lulu. And Electra tells Lulu that she wishes Candy was there and that she never really gave her a proper goodbye at the funeral. So the next thing you know, we see Angel screaming and howling for the lifeguard because Blanca ass drowning. So the lifeguard rush in the water and bring her to shore, and Electra and the girls is crying. Electra like, I can't lose another daughter, you know, because Candy was her daughter. And Blanca is out cold. The lifeguard got to give her CPR. She finally comes to, and she look up, and it's this dreamy, light-skinned man with a beard or whatever. He like, hi, and then he goes to commercial. So Lulu tells Blanca that the lifeguard was clocking her like he was feeling it, baby. And Blanca was like, he can lay it low and spread it wide, bitch. I don't even give a damn. So ain't no lick in the house. So Electra says they're going to go out to dinner. Everybody get dressed. Dinner's on her. So they head to the restaurant dressed in the nines. I loved Electra's hot pink net dress. I had something like that when I was a teenager too. It was so inappropriate for me to be a teenager having on dress like that, but whatever. So Electra and all the girls are at dinner and they ordered lobster and steak and all types of shit. And Blanca, you know, thanks Electra. She's like, I really needed this. Like, thank you, Electra. And Electra, like, finally is having a nice moment because I love that even though they can argue like cats and dogs, Electra and Blanca have each other's back. And Electra was like, no matter what we go through, I'm gonna always be there for you. You gonna always be my daughter. So after dinner, Blanca goes to the restroom. And as she's gone, this pasty white bitch in her Eddie Bauer outfit come over and basically tell the girls that they're too loud and she knows a man pretending to be a woman when she sees one. And Electra ain't having that shit. Electra done had her a couple of cocktails, bitch. You got Electra fucked up. So she stand up and she say, God may have blessed you with Barbies, a backyard with a pony, a boyfriend named Jake. My first crush was a dude named Jacob when I was in the first grade. I love Jacob. That was my first white boy crush. Jacob. I wonder where Jacob is right now. Jacob, I love you. I want to see CL Fine because he was a cute little boy. But anywho, she say a boyfriend named Jake and an unwanted pregnancy that your father paid to terminate so you could go to college and major and be a basic bitch. I was like, read, bitch. And then she say, none of these things make you a woman. Then she place her hand up like this and pause, and Lulu hand her a drink of water so she can hydrate their throat and proceed to read on. And then she says, your ill-fitting uniform of J. Crew Kulaks. I have not heard about Kulaks since I was a little girl. Nobody even wears Kulaks anymore. I need to get me a pair of Kulaks, goddammit. That's like, don't nobody even wear corduroy no more. Like, I ain't seen nobody in corduroy in forever. So, she say, fake pearls and 50 cent scrunchies cannot conceal the fact that you don't know who you are. We fought for our presence at this table, and that has made us stronger than you will ever be. Now, pick your jaw up off the floor and go back to your clam chowder and shallow conversation. My girlfriend and I aren't going anywhere. were. And that woman couldn't do shit but pop her collar and take her ass back over there and sit the fuck down and fan herself. And I was like, yes, Electra, read that bitch for filth, ma'am. So Blanca comes out of the bathroom and she runs into the lifeguard. He's on the payphone talking to his grandmama. That's another thing that ain't around no more. Payphones. Oh my God. So she tap him on the shoulder. He turn around. He get off the phone with his grandmother and he says that he's done guard. He's been, you know, lifeguarding for 6 summers and never gave CPR on anyone with lips like hers. And I was like, ah, you want another? So he asks her for a stroll on the beach. So Blanca comes back to the table, and I just knew that she was going to tell the girls that she, you know, turned him down and that she wasn't going to go. And I was like, I was going to yell at the screen, like, Blanca, have you lost your motherfucking mind, bitch? We had dick and forever. So Blanca comes back to the table, though, and tells them that he asked her for a stroll on the beach, and Electra was the one that was like, no, bitch, you ain't going nowhere with him at night. And Blanca was like, yes, the fuck I am. And Electra reminds her that they can't go out with men after dark because she might end up dead to the bed like Candy ass. So Blanca like, so I'm just supposed to live my life afraid? And Lulu was like, girl, just meet her for coffee in the morning before we leave. Blanca like, I'm going. Fuck that. So the girl's like, well, bitch, if you're going to be hard-headed about the shit, here, take these. So they give her a stun gun. They give her a knife, a switchblade, some brass knuckles, and bitch, the bitch is about to be ready. So Blanca and the dude walking on the beach. And he tells her that he's studying to be a doctor. And he asks her about her dreams. And she tells him about her salon and how it burned down and this, and that. And she brings up knowing that the outside world thinks how she knows how the outside world thinks and looks at her. And he says, you know, I know who you are. And I basically don't give a fuck. I know you got a kind spirit. And that's all I care about. And he asks her for a kiss. And she says, you know, well, I ain't stopping you. And I was like, me neither, bitch. We need this. My mind is telling me no, but my body is telling me yes. So the next morning she walking, I'm walking too with my heels and shit. We walking back to the mansion, bitch, to light as a feather. And Election him like, where the fuck you been at? We've been worried about you. We's about to call the goddamn cops and shit. And so she tells them about how everything, you know, went down and how they had a wonderful time and it was like the perfect night. And then she gave him her number, but she didn't expect too much, you know. She felt like it was just like a one night thing, like I'm gonna just take that. So Electra tells Joe that it's time for them to go home, and she tells him, you know, how lucky he is because he has a luxury of choosing loneliness, but for some people it's not optional. What a fantastic line. Whoever wrote that line, wow, that was such a line, because to be able to choose to be lonely, but to actually be lonely is two totally different things. Like, I'm in a place in my life where I'm choosing to be alone, but I don't feel lonely. You see what I'm saying? Like, I don't miss companionship. I don't lack friendship, but I like being alone. I like being by myself. I'm a loner, but I do know how it feels to be lonely in the past. And to be lonely is a horrible feeling. And a lot of people out here don't have family, don't have friends, don't have, you know, a mate or kids or whatever, and they are lonely and they are alone and they don't have someone to turn to. And that's a really fucked up feeling to have. And that was just an extraordinary line. So on the way home, they in the car singing Hold On by En Vogue, and it just took me back to the fourth grade. And Electra, as she's singing, she sees Candy Ghost sitting in the back seat, and Candy's singing along with them, and then her spirit fades away. And that's just showing us that, you know, she's at peace with Electra, like they're good. So they get back to the crib, and Blanca tells Angel that they, you know, should make this an annual girls trip every year. And Angel tells her that she'll be heading out there more than once a year now that she got an old boy. And Blanca like, girl, it was cool for what it was, but I probably won't even hear from him. He probably won't even call me. You know, it was just whatever. So Angel like, girl, you got a message on your answer machine. So she was like, it's probably just a bill collector, girl. But lo and behold, it's Adrian, the lifeguard, telling her that he been thinking about her and what they did on the beach. And she was like, hold up, bitch, go into your room while I call him back. And she calls him back. And it was just a really sweet episode. And for somebody like me that wants to be in a relationship and wants companionship, but wants it only if it's going to be right, I really love tonight's episode, because if you wait and do it the right way, you can have a good man to come into your life. And Blanca deserves happiness. We all deserve happiness. So I pray that I get a moment like Blanca had tonight, because it was just a really sweet moment. And it was good to see her win, because Blanca doesn't get a lot of wins. Everyone around her always wins, but or she's helping other people achieve what they want, and she's always an afterthought. So it was really good to see Blanca get something in her life that make her happy, that made her happy. So I give tonight's episode of Pose an A+. It was wonderful. Last week's episode was so good. So sad I couldn't have done a review on it, but you all know I was out of town. But last week's episode was crazy. That showdown at the dinner table with Damon and them, and Damon reading the fuck out of Pray Tell, bitch. It was everything. I think that Pray Tell is wrong as fuck for fucking Ricky. I think Ricky is a user. Ricky goes wherever the wind blows. I don't like Ricky ass at all, but I live for Pray Tell regardless, because Pray Tell is old and he lonely, and but he wrong for what he did, but it is what it is. I'm really excited about the new way that the show is going to go next season, with new kids going to be joining Blanca's house. We'll get new kids into the house now that Damon and Angel and them are all gone. She needs new children now. So I can't wait to see the way the show's gonna go for the third season. They have been picked up for season 3 already. I hope that they don't jump the ship like Pose did. It's looking like like Claus did. I saw a report today that said it's looking like Claus will not get renewed for season 4. Season 3 was just not good. They jumped the ship. They jumped the shark. It was just not a good season. I stopped reviewing it not even halfway into the season. I just was not feeling it. The writing just went way too left. It was way too over the top. But hopefully, like I said, Pose will keep on track of giving us good quality stories and television and great acting and great clothes and music and everything. Let's talk down below. Let me know what you think of tonight's episode. I will be doing a review on Basketball Wives tomorrow, motherfuckers. Jesus Christ. I have not stopped doing reviews on Basketball Wives. I was simply out of town and moving, you guys. Pump your brakes. Also, I'll be redoing reviews on Black Ink Crew Compton that premieres tomorrow. I'm excited about it. All right, you guys. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure to thumbs up this video, like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell button, and I will see you all tomorrow. Prayfully. Bye. Love you.